In my last video, I have explained you what is the differences between hub, switch and router. In this video, we are going to learn how hub, switch and router works in a computer network. This is going to be a completely practical video where I am going to show you the live scenario, what exactly the difference between these three devices and how these three devices works in a network. So you should watch this video till the end. Hello friends, this is Abhishek here and welcome back to my channel Technical Tech. Let's the tech begin.
Visit our website www.learnavi.com or download our Android application Networking Plus to practice networking quiz, interview questions and many more. For more information, check the link in the description section below.
So as you can see, here I have two different networks. In first network, the centralized device is hub, and on second network, the centralized device is switch. Let's find out how these two devices works in a network. So let's understand what is hub. See, hub is a broadcasting device that is used to send the data to all the devices connected to it, and it does not store any IP address or MAC address. Now how hub works in a network, let's find out. For example, this is the PC number 1 assigned with the IP address 10.0.0.1. Okay. And here we have second PC assigned with the IP address 10.0.0.2. So PC number 1 wants to send the data to the PC number 2 via hub. So what is going to happen? Let's find out. Step number 1. PC is going to send ARP message. ARP stands for Address Resolution Protocol. It is a process that is used to find the MAC address via IP address. If you want to know more about this protocol, so I have already created a separate video. I will provide you the link of the video in the description section below, so you can directly watch it from there. Okay, so PC number 1 is going to send the ARP message. Let's click on next. So hub has successfully received the message. Okay, now hub don't know who is 10.0.0.2 in this network. So for this reason, it is going to broadcast the data to all of these three PC. Let's click on next. As you can see, it has broadcasted the data to all of these three PCs. Hence, PC number 3 and PC number 4 is not 10.0.0.2. That's why they have rejected the data, saying that I am not 10.0.0.2. PC number 2 has accepted the data because it is 10.0.0.2. Now this PC is going to send back the ARP message saying that, hey, this is my MAC address and I am 10.0.0.2. Let's click on next. So the message has been reached to the hub. Now hub does not have any capability to store MAC address, so hub don't know who is 10.0.0.1, from which PC the ARP message has come from. For this reason, it is going to again broadcast the data to all of these three PC. Let's click on next. See, it has broadcasted the data to all of these three PC. Now hence, PC number 3 and PC number 4 is not 10.0.0.1, so they have rejected the data. Hence, PC number 1 is 10.0.0.1, so it has received the data. Got it? So this is the main problem of hub. Whenever it received the data, it always broadcast the data to all the devices connected to it. Let me show you one more example. See, PC has a capability to store MAC addresses. Okay, so now this PC know who is 10.0.0.2 and what is its MAC address. Okay, so for this reason, it is not going to send again the ARP message. See, if I click here, it is directly going to send ICMP message, that is Internet Control Message Protocol. This protocol is used to tell you whether the data has been successfully delivered to the user or not. Okay, and ARP message is to identify the MAC address of a device. Got it? Now if I click on next, PC number 1 knows who is PC number 2 and what is its MAC address, but hub don't know. For this reason, it is going to again broadcast the data to all of these three devices. See, it has broadcasted the data to all of these three devices. Again, PC number 2 is going to send a reply. And again, hub is going to broadcast the data to all of these devices. So this is the main disadvantage of Hub, that is always broadcast the data to all the devices connected to it, and it do not store any IP address and MAC address, and it consumes lots of bandwidth. Now let's move on to the second network, where the centralized devices switch, and let's find out how switch works in a network. Even here, PC number 1 is assigned with the IP address 10.0.0.1, and PC number 2 is assigned with the IP address 10.0.0.2. Now if you send data from PC number 1 to the PC number 2, what will happen? The PC number 1 is again going to send the ARP message, that stands for Address Resolution Protocol, because it don't know what is the MAC address of PC number 2. And without MAC address, the PC cannot communicate with each other. Now click on Next. Switch has received the data. Even switch don't know out of this 3 PC who is 10.0.0.2. So even the switch is going to broadcast the data to all of these 3 PC. Now see, once this switch has received the data from PC number 1, it is going to store the MAC address of the PC number 1, okay? And it has broadcasted the data to all of these 3 PC. Hence, PC number 2 is the PC assigned with the IP address 10.0.0.2, so it has received the data, and these 2 PC has rejected the data. Now PC number 2 is going to send the message back to the switch. So this ARP message switch has received. Now switch knows very well who is 10.0.0.1, because for the first time it has received the data from PC number 1. So it is not going to broadcast the data to all the PC. It is going to directly send the data to the PC number 1. Got it? So this is the main advantage of switch, that it is a multicast device. It only sends the data to the PC where you want to send. Got it? Now let me show you one more example. Now the PC knows who is 10.0.0.2. Even switch also knows who is 10.0.0.2, because they have capability to store MAC address. Let me show you one example. See, now if I send the data from PC number 1 to this PC number 2, what will happen? See, it is directly sending the ICMP message, and the data will reach to switch, and switch is going to directly send the data to the PC number 2. It is not going to broadcast the data again and again. Okay, only for the first time it is going to broadcast the data to identify the device. After that, it is only going to do the multicast, means where you want to send the data will only reach to that particular PC. Now let me show you how to find the MAC address. So if you go to switch, here run the command show MAC address and hit enter. Okay, so hence two devices has communicated through the switch, that is PC number 1 and PC number 2. So it has stored the MAC address of these two devices. Got it? If you send the data from PC number 1 to PC number 3, click on Next. I will show you quickly, okay, because I have already explained you how it works. So this time PC number 3 is also communicated with the switch, right? So if you go to switch, run the same command. See, this time it has stored one more MAC address. See, earlier there was only 2 MAC address. Now we have 3 MAC addresses. Now again, if you send the data from PC number 1 to PC number 4, it is going to do the same process. First of all, it is going to send the ARP message. It is broadcast the data to all the devices. PC number 4 will send the message back to switch, and switch is going to send the ARP message back to the PC. Now switch has stored the MAC address of 4th PC also. If you go here and run the same command, that is show MAC address. As here you can see, this time we have 4 MAC addresses stored in a switch. So this is how switch works in a network. See, once it has stored all the MAC addresses, means it is very easy to send the data in a network, and that is in a one attempt. See, if I send data to any PC, for example, I want to send data to PC number 2. It is directly going to send the data to the PC number 2. It is not going to broadcast the data to all the devices, because it has capability to store MAC addresses. Got it? I hope you understand what is the differences between hub and switch, and how these devices works in a network. Now let's go forward and understand how router works in a network, and what is the use of it in a network. So for this, I have created here two more networks, and in both the network the centralized device is switch. Here PC number 2 of the network 1 assigned to the IP address 10.0.0.2 and PC number 2 of the second network assigned with the IP address 20.0.0.2. Now I want these two networks to communicate with each other. If I ask, most of the students will tell that if you connect these two switch together, they will able to communicate with each other. Is it true? Let's find out. So I have connected the first switch to the second switch. Now what do you think? Are they going to communicate with each other? Let me show you one live example. Okay, it's better we do the real-time test where I'm going to run the ping command. Okay, so let's run the ping command, and command is ping ping space 20.0.0.2 and hit enter. See what it is telling. It is telling you request timed out. It means the PC is unable to communicate with the PC on another network. Got it? So for this reason, we use a router in a network. Here I have created one more scenario, and even here you can see the IP address is absolutely same, that is 10.0.0.2, and this PC IP address is same 20.0.0.2. Okay, and here in center we have placed a router. In router you have to do some configurations, directly it will not work. Okay, now if I send a data from PC number 2 to this PC number 2 on another network, it will easily going to send. Let me show you. PING ping space 20.0.0.2 and hit enter. So for the first time you will get request timed out because it is going to send the ARP message. After that you will easily get TTL message. See, if I run the command again, you will get successful reply message. Got it? It means it is able to communicate with each other using a router.
So guys, hope you have enjoyed watching this video. Then please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel right now for more videos, and also hit the bell icon. Thanks for watching.